I'm not a father. Because I have a Black Sabbath t-shirt. Dads don't get a Black Sabbath t-shirt. They get a story about how they saw Black Sabbath and they were better then and how you're wrong. I do have a father. I love my father very much. I love my father very much because we've almost beaten the shit out of each other. And that's how you grow to love each other as son and father. You have to have that moment where you look at your old man and think, I'm gonna fucking stab him in the face. And I'm gonna go to jail, and I'm gonna go to sleep every night being like, I don't give a fuck that I'm gonna have to be very scared in the shower tomorrow. I kill that old fuck. And he looks across that table at you going, look at this young son of a bitch. I'm gonna kill him, I'm gonna kill him, and they won't believe I did it, because they'll think I'm old, but I'm spry, but I didn't tell nobody about that. My father was very interesting. He's very interesting because he's always about what you deserve, what you deserve. And he never hit me. He never had to hit me. He would just show me a knife in a drawer, and that was fine. It's not true. It wasn't in a drawer. It's just against my throat while I was trying to sleep. I should not be doing this material this early into the set. I got like another 25 minutes, and we're already in the my dad tried to kill me jokes. This is going to be very hard to pull back. And we're sitting. Dylan and I chose literally the hottest, narrowest room to record an album. Yeah, the inside of a cow's asshole was not available, so we went with this one. Is there, yeah, hi, can we record an album inside an actual fire? No. All right, we'll do it here. Anyway, so my father, he would just talk to me. He would never get out enough. He would just talk to me, just explain to me what I had done wrong and why I no longer deserved what I was originally going to get. Like, when I was 10 years old, I got caught lying in March. And then in November, my father took me to see a movie. And I looked at the list of movies at the movie theater, and I said, Dad, I want to see that movie. And then he kneeled down, because I wasn't this tall then. That'll work really well on the album for them. Visual, fuck. Anyway, so kneeled down. I said, John, you don't get to decide what movie we're going to see, because you're a liar. And liars don't deserve choices. And then, when I was 16 years old, I got caught cheating on a test. Came home from school that day, my father was in the kitchen making supper, and I said, hey, Dad, what's for supper? And he turned around from the stove, and he said, John, you don't deserve to know what's for supper, because you're a cheater. And cheaters don't deserve information. And he really followed through on that threat. He sat me down at the dinner table, blindfolded me, and then whispered in my ear, could be pizza, could be poison. Smash cut to the year 2009. I move here to Toronto, and I move in with my father for 2 months. We were staying in a one-bedroom apartment because that's what my dad can afford. Don't get divorced 3 times because you have to give away half your stuff 3 times. That doesn't work. You've lost. You have to live. He's fucked, basically. Anyway. So we're living there. And one morning, I was a comedian. I still am, but I was also a comedian at that time. And I don't know if you know this about comedians, but we don't wake up early. And it's not because we're lazy. It's because we don't finish work until like 2 o'clock in the morning. And it's very hard to go to bed right away when you're like, fuck it, I'm going to get drunk and play Battleship until 5 in the morning. So we need to sleep in. But my father didn't understand it, so I'd be lying in bed. And then around 7 o'clock in the morning, he came in one morning and went, John, I'm going to work. But if you want some ice cream, you have some ice cream. I'll be going. My eyes opened immediately, and I thought, I'm a comedian. I deserve ice cream. The most hilarious of breakfast options. So I go into the kitchen there. I get the ice cream out of the freezer, put the ice cream in a bowl, I put some cereal and a banana on top of the ice cream because that's breakfast. And I am not an animal. I then go eat my delicious sugary breakfast, and then I head out onto the streets. I write some jokes and tell some jokes. I come back to the house around midnight. Now, I'd finished all the ice cream in the house, so I put the ice cream tub in the garbage can, which is where that goes. But then I came back. Thank you for the knowing laugh of foreshadowing, miss. I walk into my dad's apartment, and the tub of ice cream was not in the garbage can when I had left it. No, it was in my bed. Now, this is a very confusing moment in my life. And what do you do in that situation? Well, you turn to your father. So I ask him, hey, Dad, why is the tub of ice cream in my bed? And then he emerged from his bedroom like a dragon. You know how fathers get when they're angry? Vertebrae add to their spine. They come at you like a hangover on a weekday. Just like, oh no, this is all my fault, and yet, fuck me! You just come at, I'll throw you one of the fucking tub of ice creams in your bed because I had a very bad day at work. I got yelled at by 3 different bosses for something I didn't do, and then I came back to the house, and all I wanted was some ice cream for dessert, and there was no ice cream for dessert. It's your fault. I didn't get dessert. And for the first time in my life, I realized my father was wrong and I was right. So I stood up tall and I said, no, Dad. I didn't say no Dodd, because that's not his name. No Lou Dobbs. You remember that guy from CNN? I was a little drunk at the time, and sometimes I get drunk and see financial analysts. Would have been way funnier if I got the word fuck, anyway. It's a very hard word to say when you're angry. Try saying analyst, but yell it. Yeah. We better fucking have got that on the CD, or I'm gonna sound like a lunatic. So I pointed at him, I said, Lou Dobbs, get out of here. I can't even say your job title. Now, Dad! You listen to me. I'll tell you why I finished the tub of ice cream. I'll fucking tell you why I finished the tub of ice cream, because you, father, 28 years ago, you had sex with your wife, and you didn't use a condom, and men who don't practice safe sex don't deserve dessert. That was a bit of a rocky landing for that joke, but we made it happen. That punchline was equivalent to the time that guy landed a plane on a body of water. It happened, but everyone was going, where the fuck are we going? We're going down? Yeah, we're fucking going down.